The name of this is called concentration game. Concentration game. Have you ever played concentration with a deck of cards? You take all the cards, turn them face down, two up at a time, and try to remember their location. I find that playing cards are very thin and hard for people with stiff fingers to pick up. So I've made a set of concentration cards that is on corrugated cardboard, and also sometimes a 7 looks like a 6 and they're hard to differentiate. So I mounted these on corrugated cardboard and I used geometric shapes that looked different from one another. If you had someone with poor eyesight, you might use more color than what I have here. For example, a big red triangle or a big blue circle. I want to give you an example of the way that I use the concentration game. I usually pick closed and open shapes, and by a closed and an open shape, for example, obviously the two circles are closed and the stars are open. And I would say to the resident, this is a circle, this is a circle, this is a star. This is a circle, this is a circle, this is a star. This is a circle, this is a circle. They've just been told twice that this is a star. Can they say the word star? Can they indicate, if they can't talk, which one is the star? After they're able to name the shapes or somehow indicate, do they see these two as being different from this one? I have to know that. Then what I do is I hide one of the shapes. I just turn it over and I say, this is a circle, this is a circle. Can they name the hidden shape? Do they know what the hidden one is? If they can do name one hidden shape, I keep the cards in the same location and I turn all three down. Which ones are the circles, which ones are the stars? If they can turn them up and remember their location after they've seen their location, they've got the basic concept of the concentration game. I can add more shapes, more cards, and so on, and scramble them up, and they have the game idea. Right, so the comment here is, so you start with three and get up to a larger pattern, and that's exactly what you do. So you start off with naming. You might have a goal to name the shapes in the concentration game. A revised goal might be in 6 months to name one of the shapes that are hidden or turned over. Any questions on concentration game? Good idea. Comment back there that you can also use pictures, birds, flowers, magazine pictures. Good idea.
We had a child game for our children that had little squares like filled with different pictures. There were a lot of them, but you could reduce the number you used.
Mm-hmm. The comment over here was that there's a child's game where you take pictures and shapes and so on little squares. So there's all different ways that you can adapt this. Some people may react better to the pictures of the flowers than they would to a triangle. This is called same and different cards. Same and different cards. Is the shape on the left the same or different from the shape on the right? Well, let's see, that looks the same. Let's put that here in a box on the right. Is the shape on the left the same or different from the shape on the right? Let's see, that looks pretty much the same. Let's put that in the box here on the right. Is the shape on the left the same or different from the shape on the right? See, that looks different. Let's put that in a box here on the left. The same or different? Let's see, this is different. We put this on the left. That's what the same and different cards are, where you try to figure out, is the shape on the left the same or different from the shape on the right? What would you say about this man's working surface? Too far away, exactly right. This person had a wheelchair that you could not get the wheels of the over-the-bed table under the wheelchair. So he was, quote, sort of stuck that way. He was someone that would not leave his room, so we had to use an over-the-bed table for a working surface. Wouldn't a card table have worked? I guess I was trying to think. I've never used a card table in a nursing home, and maybe I've just never thought of it. We tried that. The comment here was, you thought that I said to turn the tables to the end and slide them this way? We tried that, and this was a four-wheeled over-the-bed table, and there was some thing about the construction of his wheelchair that we simply tried, and it just wouldn't fit. It was kind of like a Chinese puzzle getting it through there. Yes? Good idea. Masonite boards that attach with Velcro would be a solution to this kind of problem where you put the board across and you put the Velcro tabs around the person. Yes? A portable desk, the ones that have a hard top with sort of a cotton material underneath, that might be another possibility to set that on his lap. They're not very big, but maybe what we could have done is reduce the size of the cards to fit his board, but that's a good comment. The problem with this person is he had stiff fingers. We wanted him moving them, and he could only understand simple directions. The goal for him was to do same and different cards independently. The approach that we used was to encourage him with praise.